Welcome everyone to the 10:30 session resource available to you, Kohl's LMS and Tools Committee, with our presenters, Christala Smith from Southeastern Oklahoma State University, Amanda Keesee from University of Central Oklahoma, and Margot Gregory from Cameron University. Thank you.
Does this come out so that we don't have to stand right there?
I think so.
Over there.
All right, so I'm just listening. What I'm going to tell you about a little bit is what this, the background we all got going, and I'll tell you a little bit more about what we have to offer. But what we want to tell you about is a committee that we have connected to Kohl. If you don't know what Kohl is, that is the Council for Online Learning Excellence. And it's a large consortium that involves the university, the public institutions throughout the whole state. And we have a variety of committees within Kohl, including accessibility, OER, advanced technologies. One of them is LMS and Tools. And it's the newest one. And the reason that we got it going was because there's so much opportunity for us to share and collaborate on so many different tools. And just like in that wonderful presentation that we gave earlier, the tools that we have available to us are constantly changing. And it's hard to keep up, and it's hard to know who we can ask about information. At Southeastern, last year, we were doing an LMS evaluation. We knew we were going to be moving from Blackboard original. We were on original self-hosted. It had an end of life. There was no option. So we had to choose which learning management system to go to next. So we put together a committee and did a very extensive evaluation. As part of that, because I had contact information from people in Kohl, I was able to contact people who use each of the learning management systems, Blackboard, D2L, and Canvas. And we put together a panel where our evaluation committee could ask that panel anything they wanted. And that turned out to be such a great opportunity. And we got so much information that was absolutely invaluable. Later, that was in the fall, in the spring, we did another similar, not a panel, but we organized breakout rooms where we invited vendors in the morning and the afternoon, more people that were using the tools. And we expanded it to not only the learning management systems we were looking at, but other tools we might adopt in association, like videos, and accessibility tools. So yeah, that one, faculty and staff were all able to come in and talk to the people there about their experience. And we were able to have a survey after that, and that played a huge role in our decision. Well, a lot of the feedback that came as a result of that from people in Kohl and OPO were, is that something we have? And that's the role. That's why we have these state organizations, is so that we can have people we can ask. We have colleagues throughout the state that we can rely on to get information and really network, really use the value of that network. So we wanted to make it easy for other institutions to do similar things or have a similar resource. So we added a new committee to Kohl, and it's not that everyone is gonna simply be evaluating on the management system. We don't want to change those very often. Well, we do occasionally, but there are also so many other tools. There's videos, there's proctoring tools, and you name it. And tomorrow there will be another dozen, and the day after that, 20 more, and on and on. So it can be hard to keep up with, and it can, you know, if you're just talking to the vendor, it is wonderful, and you're going to get a lot of insight if you're not talking to somebody who's stupid. So we organized this committee to make a place where we could organize references and have some people that were keeping up with what tools were out there, what people were using, and be able to get information or connect people. And that is the LMS and Tools Committee at Kohl. And I'm going to let them tell you a little bit more from here.
Thank you so much. So
Right now, myself and Margot are actually co-chairing the LMS and Tools Subcommittee. Margot has really kind of kept me on track this year, which is fantastic. I need that, help along the way. So it's been great to kind of get together and develop this committee and kind of develop a vision for it for the future. Last summer, during the summer, I can't remember if it's called a retreat that called us, but we got together to talk about this committee and what those goals and what that vision would look like. And you can see on the slides up here kind of what came from that discussion. And it was really great to kind of talk to everyone that was interested in this kind of a topic about what we saw this committee being, because we had a real opportunity here to develop it the way that we wanted to see it, to make it useful to us and to our institutions. And it allowed us really to gear our goals and our vision and mission to what we saw would be best for us. And so as Christala was talking about, really some of the key goals are to provide resources to institutions upon request. So one of the big things that we've been kind of talking about is that we're not going to recommend product A versus or over product B. Like, that's not really the goal. What we're here to do is kind of provide insights and resources related to particular technology tools, integrations, or LMSs if necessary. And so we've done a lot of things over the last year that have kind of led us towards that. And I'll talk about that here in just a second. It's also been a place to facilitate information sharing. And so it's a great place where we've had lots of really interesting discussions about different topics. Some of them have come up naturally. Some of them are things that we've planned ahead of time. And so one of my favorite things that have come out of it is actually we got requested for information to provide to somebody, which is really what we want to do, because we got to come in and say, okay, what is everybody doing to address this particular issue or concern? And we shared what all of our different universities are doing and what all of our different institutions are doing, which was an excellent insight, because rather than just thinking of it through the lens of my location, I got to hear what other people were doing. And I even thought to myself, hey, you know what? That's an area we need to look into. I hadn't even considered that. Or here's another piece of information that I wish I had known before we started that thing there. So even providing information to others was insightful to the rest of us. We also are looking at a bunch of discovering new tools, trying to share that information out with each other. I don't know about you, but I get emails from vendors daily, multiple ones. And so it's really hard to keep track and up to date with what's available out there and what's worth looking into and what's not. So that's some of the information that we've brought back to each other. Harmonize was one that I had never heard of before. And I think Margot or brought it up to our committee. And now it's something I'm incredibly interested in. I hope that we can someday get it at our university. Because I see that it meets a lot of goals, but I don't know if I would have ever heard of that if she hadn't brought it to the table. And I believe you're going through a pilot right now, which has provided a lot of insight to the rest of the team on rest of the committee on how that process is going and whether it is worthwhile to continue looking into products like that. So there we go, that works. Okay, so some of the things I'll talk to you about that we have done so far, kind of hinted at several of them, but one of the big things that Christala had started before the committee formed and that the committee is now kind of taking on to keep updated is a tools spreadsheet. Simon started it. Oh, I'm so sorry. Thank you, Simon, for this. It's an excellent resource because what it is every institution has put their information into there about the contact person and the particular tool they're using for different things. So what's your SIS? What is your LMS? What is your video streaming service? And what that has allowed us to do is, to Christala's point about when they were looking at LMSs, it gave us contact people to go and ask these questions to. And it wasn't just us hunting for information or calling a random number and begging somebody to tell us who to reach out to. We have those people, a lot of them are people we know from the other committees and from COLE as a whole. And it's given us a really good overview into what other institutions are doing. And I think one of the things that really for me was a benefit is that we've been talking about why they've selected specific tools. And some of its size, some of its budget, and some of those things apply to my university and some don't.
but it gives me that insight that vendors do not, and allows us to kind of go past the sales pitch and really get to the meat of what's going on with those tools. So we have had integration demos. We have had some vendors come out and show us a couple of things. They're 15 to 30 minutes long, real quick. Here's what we can do at a high level. And then we hand out information if people want more. But what I really like is we also have done a couple of peer demos where instead of having the vendor come in and show the product, we've had the people that are using it and value it show how to use that tool and what you can do with it. And I found that much more insightful for me, much more helpful because I again, getting past that sales pitch, getting to see it in action, getting to see where it was really easy to get to something and where some of it takes a little bit of extra work, which are the things you need to know before you really adopt some of these tools. And then finally, I wanted to talk a little bit about just that information sharing again, where we're going in and we're kind of sharing with each other what we're doing at our universities, what things are coming up. You know, when we first met again in January, I believe ChatGPT was obviously something that got brought up, and it has been consistently brought up at every meeting. But what we've done is we've kind of started a resource list of sharing and information that we can then take back and go back to our other groups and committees about. So it's been really helpful in that respect. So, Margo, I will turn it over to you to talk about the open discussions working groups.
So, I'm not a professor, I'm a trainer, and I'm the LMS admin. And so for me, this group is really helpful because I'm not only getting information on software that other institutions are using, but we're also getting the information on how is the tech support for the software. And those things are really beneficial to be shared too, because the greatest software in the world is no good to me if it breaks and their tech support is horrible. So this is another really great benefit for this group. We can share that information, which is really important when we're on the ground, and, you know, midterms and things break. You know, we can't have that. Now, the things that we want from our group is feedback on what do you need? What would you like to learn? What would you like for us to present next? We really want questions. We love feedback, not just how things work, but also what would you like to know? And not just about software that actually has a vendor and costs money, because there's a lot of software out there and that we could use at no cost. And will it really work? Is it beneficial? So those are the kind of things that we try to organize in our, the type of information that we like to distribute and gain from each other and make it really collaborative.
Oh, I did want to say one more thing about some of the open discussions and stuff that we've had. As I said, you know, we do have these discussions and that where we bring specific topics to the group and say, okay, let's talk about this. But we've also had some just kind of open discussions where people have brought up things to us. And I think one of the things that I really learned a lot from was this random discussion we had about how integrations are approved and adopted at the different universities and what kind of technology review process they go through. And so, you know, that was actually something that was really pertinent to my job in my area at the time. And so it helped get some insight into some of the struggles that other groups were going through, but also some of the things they had done to overcome those pieces, and has given me some information to go back to the teams on my campus with. I think the other thing that had really helped is that some of this information that has been shared has given me a backup for things that I want to do at my university. I can say, you know, well, our committee has found that, you know, five other universities are doing this in the state. Maybe this is an opportunity to get some kind of state contract, or maybe this is an opportunity to get some resource and sharing from them. Or even better, hey, look, they're saying it works, so let's do it. We, you know, we can make this happen at our university too. Here's the benefits that they found. So the open discussions and that information sharing has just been invaluable to us in that respect. So I'll let Margot talk about getting information.
Right. Yeah. So what we really like to know is, how can we help you? What type of information would you like for us to research for you to bring to the table? And also you can reach us in the committee through Cole and email us directly to bring up information. So there, we just really like to have your feedback and your input and active collaboration.
How are you getting back? Like,
we could repeat the question if you want to do it that way. Oh, there it is.
Giving your information back to the institution. I know that you mentioned LPI integration to the institution is overcoming all the obstacles of improving those. How are you giving that information back to the different institutions?
A lot of it is kind of relying on our committee members to go back to their institutions with the information they need. We each have varying roles. You know, I'm a part of IT, but I also work with partnerships on our campus for all of the individuals that do our instructions and our instructional design programs. And so, you know, I take that information back out to the people on my campus that can use it. Also, that information that spreadsheet, sorry, that we have out there is available for all of the committee members, not just the ones that are in our subcommittee. Everybody in COLE has access to that as a resource. And so we really are looking to our members to be able to take that information back. We do have notes that we keep after every meeting with all of the details. Anything that's shared in the chat, we try to copy into the notes as well as links. And then we even have all of the meetings recorded, so that if there is information that they want to take back, they can easily get to it. Another thing that we have done is that we, when we know we have a topic coming up, we try to send it out ahead of time and then invite committee members to say, hey, this may not be your area of expertise, but if there's somebody on your campus that you think wants to know this information, share the link with them and invite them to the meeting. So you don't have to be a member of the subcommittee or even COLE to attend our meetings. And actually, I think they've given us some good insight into some other universities as well. And I think it's brought a few members into COLE. I think Margot joined COLE because of this subcommittee. So it gives us the opportunity to kind of branch out and reach out to other individuals as well. Oh, lots of questions. I'm going to go ahead and switch.
I'm just curious if anyone or any information on how people incorporate the virtual reality, especially in things like tornado drills, fire drills, shooter.
Specific topics, not necessarily, but we actually have the chairs of the Advanced Technologies Committee sitting at the table right there, and they cover virtual reality with there. So we've done a virtual reality project at Southeastern, and then we partnered with OneNet on that. And because of that, OneNet has a VR toolkit available to institutions, which includes a 360 camera and haptic. So you can work with them. They can connect you. There's a form. It's very easy to get connected with them. As part of that, we also have some meetings with some of that OneNet every other Friday to check in and collaborate and see if we have anything to help each other with any questions as we go. Alicia Reidenauer and Simon Greenfield.
Should we make them like stand up and, you know, no, I'm just kidding.
So something that I've been working on at our institution is having some type of professional development workshop every month for faculty, not mandatory. But I've started that this year and have had overwhelming success. And so I developed a survey that I sent out, and unanimously faculty wanted to learn more about writing space, not just how to use the grade book, all that stuff, but to really dig deeper. And I really struggled finding someone from the institution to provide that training. Is that something that you have available?
We have the spreadsheet and know exactly who the contacts throughout the state are that use Brightspace. So yeah, I can give you names right after this meeting if you want.
They don't cost $1 million, right?
They're colleagues. They're just members of the poll.
Okay.
And we've done a lot. I know I've gone to institutions to demo our PR project and other things. Through Coal, we've done a lot of networking and helping other institutions, either providing resources or I've found everyone extremely helpful and cooperative.
That's exciting to you.
I just would like to put something on the agenda to find out and even think about adding this, but first of all, I'd like to know what tools different institutions are using for embedded course evaluations.
I know. where's my notebook? Perfect. Thank you so much.
The question that I have is, we're looking into getting a marketing for email. And so whenever I've been given the task of creating these emails, I say these emails, because I have all of a sudden be this fancy designer. And it's like, okay, you have all these great tools like S'more and a bunch of other ones out there where it's already built in and you just plug everything in. I think there's even one at UCO that we use, starts with an A, I think. Anyway, to get to that process where it goes a little bit faster, I know there's at one point where there's like technology grants available, and by the time I submitted it, it was like the window had closed.
So I think what you're talking about is Coal, and that, I mean, there are opportunities, so I don't know when there might be another one, but at a minimum, what we can do is help kind of investigate those tools. I'm not familiar with that in particular, but what we can do as a committee is reach out to all the other institutions and find out who at what institutions would have information, and then we can either connect you with them, or we can have a meeting where they come with you and everyone.
Does everyone know that each institution has an OCO rep or a full rep? It's a person that you probably should reach out to your campus. And if you're not able to reach that person, then definitely reach out to someone on one of the committees or one of those regions.
I just thought I would add, I do know that some groups did apply for a technology, I believe it was some kind of grant through, I should probably let you talk about it. They're doing it, so.
Yeah, so we applied for the technology grant to pilot Harmonize, and without that grant, we would have never been able to pilot because, you know, money is tight, and we love it. So it was very helpful to us to have that that grant.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I was going to say, I think that that's one of the wonderful resources that Coal and the regents and whatever are providing, is that the opportunity to try out products. Maybe can't fund it for us, but I mean, at least it gives us a little bit of money to get started to try some different things. And that's where we're getting some of this feedback about some of the different tools, is for these groups are trying them for the rest of us, basically, and telling us how it's going and what they're learning from it. I don't know how much, do we still have some time or we need to wrap up? Time is up. Okay, so our contact information is on the screen. Thank you all so much for your time today. We'd love to hear from you if you have any ideas or topics you'd like for our committee to look into or to discuss as a group. And we'd be happy to talk to you about joining or joining Coal
if you're interested. So thank you all so much for your time today.
Thank you.